Hello everyone, so welcome back in this video. So today we are going to learn about gyroscopic principle. So what is a gyroscope? Well, a gyroscope is an instrument which helps to provide stability to objects. Now gyroscope has many applications in rockets. So gyroscopes are used in rocket to make sure that the rocket follows a steady path. It does not deviate from its path. If you follow cricket, then gyroscope has application in cricket as well. So many fast bowlers, they swing the ball, right? They bowl in swinging and out swinging deliveries. So when they swing the ball, so they maintain the seam of the ball at a particular angle, and when they release the ball, they want to make sure that the seam remains in that position. So for that, how does that happen? So gyroscope has a role to play. So, as we can see, gyroscope has zillions of applications. So in this video, in today's video, we will learn about the principle, behind the gyroscopic action. And in the next video, I will talk about different applications, which I just mentioned, of gyroscope. So let's see. Let's get started. Okay, so let's say I have a disc as shown in this yellow line. So let's say we have a disc of mass small m, okay, and there is a rod which passes through the center of the disc as shown by this blue line, and the disc is free to rotate about the rod, free to rotate about the point where the rod passes through the disc. So let's assume that there's a bearing over here. The rod is a shaft, so the disc is free to rotate. Let's assume that the rod is massless for the time being. So only the disc has mass m. And let's say there is a thread which is tied to the ceiling, and we have a thread as shown by this white line. So let's say a thread is hanging, and the rod and disc system is connected to the thread, and initially they have been kept horizontally. So let's orient that disc and rod horizontally initially, and then let's remove our hand. So what will happen? Well, it's a no-brainer, right? This disc and rod will fall down. They will fall down like this. So why will it fall down? Because we have weight of the disc, which is mg, acting in onward direction, and so about this point this weight will have a torque, will apply a torque on this system, and that torque will be in the clockwise direction, and because of which the system will fall. So now let's rotate this disc. Rotate this disc about this rod in this direction. Okay, so let's give this disc an angular velocity denoted by omega s. And again, let's give this angular velocity to the disc initially, and then again let's keep this rod and disc system horizontally. And again, the tie to the rod to this thread. So then, what do you think? What will happen? So will this rod again fall down? What will happen? What do you think? Well, as we'll see later, this rod and this disc now will not fall. It will not fall like this. It will not fall. So that's why will that happen? So that will happen because of gyroscopic principle, and that's what we are going to see now. So now when I rotate this disc by giving it an angular velocity omega s, so this disc will have an angular momentum. Okay, and what will be the value of the, what will be the and what will be the direction of the angular momentum? So since the disc is rotating in this direction, omega s, which is counterclockwise direction, so if we orient our, as we have seen in the video on rotational mechanics, so to find the direction of angular momentum, what do? We orient our finger along the direction of the rotation. So if we do that, the direction where the thumb will point will be the direction of the angular momentum. So here, if we rotate our, if we orient our fingers, I mean, around this omega s, then our thumb will actually point in I cap direction. So that will be the direction of the angular momentum. So if you have doubt in this, please go through my video on rotational mechanics basics, which where I've explained this. So yeah, so the angular momentum of the rod will be, L vector will be what I, which is the moment of inertia of this disc, into omega s, and the direction would be I cap. Direction would be I cap. So if I represent it here, it will be around this direction. So L vector will be around this direction. Okay. Now on this system, so we are making this, all the observations from this point, this reference point O. So on this rod plus disc system, is there, we have an external force which is mg, okay, and we have a thread here, okay. So the thread will have a tension force. So let the tension force be T. So since the rod will not accelerate in the upward or downward direction, so tension force will be equal to mg, okay. But this weight mg, this will also, you know, apply a torque on this rod and disc system. So what will be the torque? The torque which will be applied by this mass mg will be r vector cross mg vector, I mean mg vector, okay. Now what will be the direction, what is the direction of r vector? R vector is along I cap, and mg vector is along minus k cap. So I cap cross mg is along minus k cap. So if we do the dot product, if we do the cross product rather, we will get the direction of torque as m, the value of torque as mgr j cap, okay, mgr j cap. So this torque will act in, the torque will act in this direction, in the j cap direction. So this external torque due to the weight mg will be given by mgr j cap. So we all know that torque is the rate of change of angular momentum, okay. So let's assume that let's initially assume that this external torque acts for a time dt, for a very small interval dt, okay. So in that small interval dt, what additional angular momentum that this torque due to the disc will impose on the and the rod system? So in that small time interval dt, the additional torque will be given by dl, let us call it dl, is equal to tau vector dt, okay. And so what will be the direction of the additional angular momentum? That will be the same as the direction of torque, which we know is j cap. So this additional, so let's denote this additional angular momentum dl. So this is dl, and the direction is in j cap, in the same direction as that of torque. So what final angular momentum of this disc after a torque acts on it for a small time interval dt? So the final angular momentum after the time interval dt will be given by this vector. It will be the vector sum of these two vectors. So let's call this L dash vector, and let's call this angle theta. So let's try to see this picture really. So what do we see? We see that initially when it was rotating with momentum omega s, angular velocity omega s, the angular momentum was in along I. Then a torque acted on it along j cap. Because of that torque, the final angular momentum is so what has happened? The initial angular momentum has turned towards the torque, okay. It has tried to follow the torque, okay. So the angular momentum in the pursuit of following the torque, it has slightly rotated. It has rotated in the ij plane, right? So in that small time interval dt, it has rotated by this angle theta, or let's call it d theta. Let's call it d theta. Well, this is an important observation to understand how the disc has responded to an additional torque. A rotating disc has responded to an additional torque. So when the disc was not rotating, as we saw earlier, because of this torque, what did we see? We see that this disc would have fallen like this. But now, since the disc is rotating, it is not simply falling like this. What is happening is that a rotating disc is actually repositioning its angular momentum. And in what direction is it repositioning? It is trying to reposition the momentum by actually chasing the torque. So on this disc, the torque because of mg is in j cap direction, right? It is in j cap direction, okay? And the initial angular momentum of this disc is along I cap direction. So what has happened is that the final angular momentum position is this L dash vector, which, so in other words, the angular momentum is trying to chase the torque. So so this is a very important to understand. Under what, like in what orientation of the disc can the disc have can the disc have this angular momentum? So the disc can have this. For the angular momentum of the disc to change from this to this, what will happen? The disc will rotate about this center O. So in other words, what will happen is that the choose the same color. So let's say, So the disc will reposition itself somewhat like this, and the disc will somewhat reposition itself like this, because of which the disc will have an angular momentum like this. Okay. So what will happen? The disc will reposition. The disc will rotate, right? And this rotation, so the disc will respond by rotating. By rotating thread in the IJ plane. Okay, so instead of falling, the disc will start to rotate. It will start to rotate about this, about the K cap, about K cap. So a rotating disc under the influence of an external torque will respond to the torque by not falling like this, but by rotating. About the thread, about this K cap, okay. And so this disc and rod system will have two rotation. The first rotation is omega s, right, which is the initial angular velocity. Now, because of this torque, the disc will respond by not falling but by rotating. So that, along this K cap direction, so this disc and rod mass system will have another angular velocity about K cap, which is called precession angular velocity, omega p. Okay, now let's try to calculate omega p. Okay, so let's again get back to this this triangle, this diagram. So in time interval dt, this is the final angular momentum. So what is dl? So we know that for a very small angle d theta, we have read earlier in our mathematics and physics video. So for a very small angle d theta, in this triangle, dl vector will be equal to what? It will be equal to l vector d theta. And what is dl vector? Dl vector is torque d, which is equal to vector d theta. Now what is d theta by dt? So d theta by dt is what? Is nothing but the precession angular velocity, which is omega p, which is equal to torque vector by L vector. So the pres by L vector. So the precession angular velocity is the ratio of torque by the initial angular momentum. Now what is torque vector? So torque vector is mgr. And what is L vector? L vector is the moment of inertia of the disc, which is I into omega s. So this is very important. So omega p is equal to mgr by I omega s. So the precession angular velocity of this disk is inversely proportional to the spin velocity, the initial spin velocity of the disk. So this is very important. So what do we see? The precision angular velocity is inversely proportional to the initial spin velocity. So what does this mean? So initially, if I give this particular disk a very high omega s, so what will happen? This disk will slowly rotate about the k cap, about the thread. However, if the omega s is small, then this disk will rotate faster. Also, if the weight is very high, so if the weight is more, then the numerator will be more, then again the disk will rotate about this k cap faster. So here and last but not the least, the direction in which the disk will rotate, that direction will be what? So that direction will be the direction of the torque. So in this, with this disk, what happens after time interval? The torque. So at this, in this position of the disk, we saw that the torque acts in j cap direction. So the angular momentum tries to follow the torque, and it moves in this l dash l dash direction, l dash vector. Now in this position of the disk, when the disk has moved to has repositioned itself along l dash vector, when the angular momentum of the disk has repositioned along l dash vector, again torque is acting on this disk, right? So at every position on the, at this position also, this disk is under the influence of a torque. So again this l dash will change. So what will happen is that this disk will continuously keep on rotating, because at every position along its rotation, torque mg is acting. So this disk will go on continuously rotating. Okay, now let's say if I reverse the direction of the initial angular momentum, the angular velocity of the disk. So initially, now in this our calculation, it was rotating in counterclockwise direction. If I reverse it, if I give an initial angular velocity in clockwise direction, then what will happen? The direction of precession will be reversed. So the disk will, instead of precessing in that direction, it will about k cap, it will start moving in the opposite direction, in this direction. Okay, so just keep two things in mind, whenever a body is spinning, that spinning body comes under the influence of an additional torque. So instead of falling directly, the angular momentum, or the initial angular momentum of the spinning body, will try to chase the torque. So it will move, it will reorient in the direction towards the torque. That is number one. And as it will reorient, it will rotate. And rotation is called precession, and the rate of rotation, which is the precession angular velocity, will be inversely proportional to the its initial spin angular velocity. So hope this concept is clear to you. I know this concept is not easy. It's one of the difficult concepts in physics. So just give yourself some pause. Repeat the video. Just rewatch the video if you have any doubt. And if you have any further question, post in the comment section. I will try to answer. But this is the basic principle of gyroscope. So in the next video, I will show you some of the applications of gyroscope. So thank you. Thanks for watching.